Hello everybody, this is Brendan. Welcome back to another video. And today we are going to be exploring a lighting technique in possibly my favorite movie from this year, 2022. The movie Everything Everywhere All at Once has a very cool lighting technique. If you haven't seen the movie, definitely go check it out. In the movie, the characters travel through dimensions, and when they do so, there's a very, very cool lighting technique. It's almost like a ring light around the lens that's shining on the actors. That is shifting between colors and also kind of spinning a bit like this. And it creates a slight shift in the shadows and of course all the color shifting as well. So one of my favorite things about lighting when it comes to cinematography is how it can be used for so many different purposes than people really realize. It's not just about making an image lit and exposed. Lighting can of course be used to change the mood of the shot, but it can also be used to change what time of day the shot feels like. It can be used to reference off-screen space or off-screen action that's taking place. So I think whether we're figuring out exactly the technique that was used in this movie or whether we are creating our own techniques, I think the most important takeaway from this is looking at how can we use lighting in a more artistic, metaphorical way, using it to create a certain feeling, create a certain emotion. 尽管离家让我心碎，我想告诉你，如果有来生，我还是会选择和你一起包睡，开始一天。And yeah, it's a really touching movie. It's too much to even try to describe in a video, so if you haven't seen it, then I highly recommend you go watch it. If this video does anything for you, I hope it convinces you to go watch this movie. It really touched me and inspired me to, you know, remind me what I love about filmmaking and why I got into this business in the first place. So I hope you all watch the movie and I hope you find this tutorial interesting. So as far as I understand it, the way that they did this technique in this movie is they used these lights called Astera Titan tubes, which are lights that I've shown in this channel before in a previous lighting tutorial for a John Wick scene. So if you want to go check that out, link to it will be in the description. But I have one here to show you. This is an Astera Titan tube. Basically, it is a light tube, an RGB LED light tube that is fully battery powered. It gets very bright and it is completely adjustable from a screen and series of buttons right here on the back. So it's very easy to use. There are some threads on each end for screwing things onto it. And the kit also comes with some clamps that can clamp onto it. So you can clamp this to a C-stand. You can put it on a little tripod, a little leg tripod to stand it upright like that. The other cool thing is these can be paired to a Bluetooth transmitter that I have today as well. And that transmitter can be connected to an app on your phone. So the Astera app on your phone can be used to control these lights through Bluetooth. The cool thing about that is you can connect multiple lights together to be controlled all simultaneously. So it shouldn't be too hard to set these lights up. Essentially, these lights are set up kind of in a triangle pattern where you have one light above, another light like this, and another light like this. So you have a triangle of lights. Creates a really cool triangular reflection in the eyes, which you can actually see in the character's eyes in the movie, so that's how you can tell which lights they're actually using. I've used these lights a lot, but I have not used the Astera app before, so we're gonna be exploring the Astera app together and try to figure out exactly if we can program something in that looks pretty similar to the movie. Okay, so as you can see, we're outside, and behind me I have the Astera Titan tube set up in a triangle formation. So it's really easy. It's just on a C-stand with a gobo arm going across, and then it's clamped into the gobo arm. And then I have the other two kind of hanging off the side from their own clamps with some tape and then zip tied on the bottom. Kind of sketchy, but you know, it gets the job done. I'm sure on the real shoot they had more grippage to actually hold it like this, but that's probably basically how they would have done it as far as the putting it on a single stand and the orientation goes. If I stand back here, let me adjust the focus. There we go. If I stand back here, you'll see it probably needs to be a little bit higher, but it's actually not bad. Raise it up a little bit. So now it's, my head is at about the center of the triangle. So what I'm gonna do is put this just in front of the lens, so that way it'll be basically a ring light around my face. But before we get to that, let's turn all the lights on. This is the AsteraBox, which I was talking about before. This is what will allow me to use the Bluetooth with the app to control the lights. So first things first, we'll turn all the lights on. So I can turn all the lights on just with the power button in the back. And you press each one. And then there's the other power button. Okay, so my phone is screen recording. I have the Titan box here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my camera controls to my Astera app, open that up. We will go over to the left here where it says, you are not connected to the Bluetooth bridge, please connect and try again. So I'll tap that. Then I believe I hit, there are no bonded Bluetooth bridges, tap here to add some, and then hit AsteraBox. Please power on your AsteraBox. So I'm gonna power this on. Okay, it turns on. Make sure that it is not connected to another app. It shouldn't be. Hit OK. And it found the AsteraBox. And I'm going to hit this. I guess I'll hit USA, Australia. OK. Now it's just doing a quick setup. Enter code shown on the AsteraBox. OK, so now I have to find where the code is. Pair. And there we go. Now it's paired. The battery's only at 20%, which is sort of a shame. When I rented this, the guy said it was at 100, and I've been charging it the last 2 hours, so it takes a while to charge, which is a shame. Hopefully 20% is enough to get us through this tutorial. But now that that is connected, now I should be able to basically sync all of my lights. So now I should, well, let me make sure my focus is racked. Okay. Now I'm going to go behind the lights. I'm going to press and hold each power button for 3 seconds, and it should start flashing blue. Do that for this one. Press and hold for 3 seconds. And then the final one, press and hold for 3 seconds. Okay. The flashing blue means that they're all trying to connect to Bluetooth. So now, let me see if I can remember how to do this. Is it in, do I hit all lights? No, do I hit the plus button? Okay, so I figured out what the problem is. I actually had to hit in this menu. So when you're in the bottom left tab, if you go up to the top right, where you are looking at your AsteraBox settings, if you hit the button that says pair with lights, that will do it instead of using the radio pin. I guess somehow it worked when I just hit the pair with lights button. So cool, we figured that part out. Now let's see if we can actually control the colors of this thing. So, let me back up a little bit. I'm gonna go into the next tab over. Okay, so after a lot of trial and error, a lot of messing with this app, I think I finally figured out how this works. So I was able to get them all synced up in order so that one goes to the next, goes to the next. And as you can see, I have a rainbow effect and it's creating one big rainbow across all three lights. And I had to make sure that the direction of the pixels, of the travel of the pixels, was also correct. So there's a few things that I figured out here. First, you want the flow effect in this tab here. So if you hit add and you go to flow set, this says to stretch effects through several lights, the lights build together a big virtual light with many pixels. So that's what I clicked for that. First I clicked that, and then I made it the rainbow effect. So that's in this tab here. I hit rainbow on that. Then you go into the next tab, which is where you can make some other adjustments. So I'm in rainbow here. And I don't know why it just paused there. That was weird. Why did it just pause? I thought I had everything figured out, and then it paused on me. Do I just hit play again? Speed? Oh. Oh, okay, that was weird. The speed just like reset. Okay, so there we go. The only difference between this versus the one in Everything Everywhere All at Once is the size of the color was larger in that. So basically all three lights were like all blue at once, and then they all slowly started shifting purple and then red and then yellow, you know. So I haven't figured out how to stretch the color of the light further across all of the lights. I'm sure that's something that you can definitely do, but for now, some troubleshooting, that looks pretty good. I can also adjust the brightness from this menu, so if I dim the brightness down, you can see I can turn it off, and then I can slowly bring it in, and then slowly make it so bright that it overexposes a little bit. It looks really cool on my face, as you can see the way it's lit here. So I think the next step is to put this in front of the lens and shine it on my face and see what that looks like. So let's do it. I like that speed and everything. I'm gonna put my phone in my pocket now, and we'll just pick this whole thing up and move it over there. This will be fun. Okay, so that is going to go just so that the camera doesn't see it. Oh, hell yeah, that's dope. So, sandbag that. And now we have sort of the effect from the movie. It's kind of similar. Let me increase the brightness. Actually, that's full brightness. So there we go. Yeah, not much else to it. Maybe I will turn my key light off here. Turn that off to make this a little bit better. But yeah, I will adjust the tilt of the camera a little bit. Tilt that up. Oh, am I even in focus? Oh yeah, I'm kind of in focus, okay. So there we go, the Everything Everywhere All at Once effect. It's not perfect, but for a few minutes, basically testing this out for the first time ever, it's kind of pretty close. I think the only difference really is, like I said, the size of the rainbow should be larger. But that's pretty cool, I dig it. I can't really tell from the screen just up here that I'm looking at, but you should see a nice triangular reflection in my eyes, which is exactly what's in the movie. So pretty darn cool. Yeah, I hope you guys like that. This kind of format of video where I'm just kind of like experimenting and don't really know what I'm doing and kind of figuring it out as I go. I know it's, as far as tutorials go, it's not exactly me showing you as like an experienced professional how these things are supposed to be used, but hopefully you found it entertaining. And I think it's really cool kind of like trying out the techniques of Hollywood movies and seeing how close we can get. And these are the exact tools that Everything Everywhere All at Once used. The Asteras with the AsteraBox, just using it as a phone app or an iPad app. And yeah, obviously I need to learn the app a little bit better and figure out, you know, get better at just like customizing the colors and the effects and stuff. But yeah, anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know what you think in the comments or if you have any questions. And yeah, this was a fun one.